Hi guys, to everyone, I'm Ada from Poison Rock, and I have the pleasure to have with us today Matthias from Fintroll and the Oceans and so on. How are you, Matthias?
Oh, I'm really good. You know, it's we're just having great weather outside, and you know, summer festivals are about to start, so
all good here. Yeah, I mean, last time we spoke, basically we were during the pandemic, which was, of course, for each one of us, we were stuck in.
Yeah.
So as it's just starting after that, all these years, I mean, you got back to touring, and I saw that you actually still did some live some weeks ago, some days ago as well, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah.
So how did it go? I mean, how did you feel to come back after all that period in the stage?
Yeah, it was kind of a couple of really bad years there. You know, we had to stay home, to try to do something new with our lives for a couple of years. You know, we used to touring all the time, and been living off that for so many years. So it was kind of a new situation for us. But, you know, now, yeah, as I said, we're back on tour, and I'm actually touring with two bands right now, as you said, and Oceans and Fintroll. And you know, we have 2 years of missed gigs to do. Mm-hmm. So right now it's been on tour for almost half a year now in in the last 180 days.
Okay, probably. So we have
90 gigs, so.
How many?
Yeah, 80-90 gigs in the last half year.
Oh my God, that's impressive. I mean, almost every day, like one day off.
Yeah, if we count it like that, but usually it's more days in a row, of course, and then a couple of days in between at home instead. But you know, yeah, it's been a hectic half a year since. We're just making up for lost time.
Yeah.
Both Fintroll and Oceans, we have both bands have a sort of new albums out, so making the best of it.
Because with Fintroll, the last album that was being released was in 2020.
Yeah.
So basically, you're just playing for the first time the album live now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And how the fans reacted? I mean, because of course they just, you know, hear it online, you know, through the platform, and see it playing live after all this time and during the lockdown. It's just really, you know, like all happy fans out there.
Yeah, exactly. It's been cool because, you know, usually when you release an album, you go straight after the release, you go on tour. So I remember when we did the Niflheim album 10 years ago, or 13 years ago, we had it on the release date. That was on a Friday. We had the first gigs of the tour. It was on that Friday, so people had a couple of hours to listen to the album, you know, before the show. So nobody knew the songs, and people were like, this is strange because we had never heard these songs. And so now people have had 2 years to listen to the songs.
I learned the lyrics.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, exactly. So it seems like, you know, people appreciate it more now because they know the songs. It's they already sort of become familiar to the people. So it was a totally new experience to do it like this. But it's been really cool. You know, the reception has been awesome.
I think as well, every one of us is appreciating more the time and the music as well. Going to the live, we enjoy more, and you saw better than me, a lot more affluence of people, more people coming to the gigs than the previous time, because now it's everyone going everywhere. Lot of festivals, time.
Yeah, awesome. Even here in, you know, two Fridays ago, I went to three gigs here in my little city. So, you know, it was on the same day, there were actually four gigs to go to, but I could make only to three of them because of the time schedule. So yeah, it's all the bands are out there right now, playing everywhere. So,
but it's good. It means that we are back to how it was before, hopefully. But just let's speak about, because of course in the first interview we spoke a little bit about FinTroll, how you joined FinTroll, and as well the Ocean not so much, so I want to focus as well because there is a new album released. But I want to start about how Matthias got in touch. I mean, you know, when you get in touch with music, your beginning in your music, when you were a teenager, you know, and kid. So
yeah. Well yeah, I've been sort of focusing on music my whole life. That's well, I started my first band when I was really small. I was I was like 7 years or something when I had my first band. So I've been
7 years.
Yeah, I have some recordings from some we did, you know, with a cassette player.
Yeah, of course.
Push the record button and then you rehearse or something. And I think the first tapes are from like 89 or something like that. So it's been all my life, and you know, before that, I come from like a music family in that kind of sense. My dad was touring with bands when I was a kid, and
the
music was always there, you know, through my whole life. So so it, you know, here we are. I never thought that I would be doing anything else than
the music.
You know, the music for my life. And you know, when I got a little bit older, when my bands didn't, you know, go as they, you know, I didn't get any like record deals with my bands that I had, I started to work in the music industry, but on the other side, as a like a sound engineer working with live concerts, but as a technician. And and then in 2006, I joined FinTroll, and then it got, you know, into the next gear, you know, leveled up with the, and then I actually took a little bit easy with the live music that I and the studio work that I did and all that kind of things.
Are you still doing that? Like something?
I'm still doing it, and I'm actually now during the pandemic I had time to build my own studio as well. So I'm here in city, we are a couple of guys that we rent this big place. We are nine people, and we have built a studio there, and taking bands right now. So we have had a couple of recordings over there, but you know, it's now I'm back on tour, so I don't really have the time to book any artists there. But as soon as, you know, the gig pace is slowing down a little bit, I'm gonna have some customers. Yeah, exactly. But you know, back in the day, you know, when I started studying sound engineering and started working in studios, then music was more of my hobby. You know, I was playing in bands was my hobby. Now it's the other way around.
But it's a. Yeah, it's always as well. I think it's important because you have the background of the sound engineering. It's helpful when you're actually playing live. You can do it by your own. You can understand.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, I don't need a sound engineering. Or
you can like, and also when you are working in a studio with a new album, it's also helpful. You know, when you know all the tricks in the book, you know.
I mean growing up, like you mentioned, your first like for example the first band was when you were 7 years old, just really young. But what we can say about your main influences, you mean when you were young, not too bad, like back in the day, even when you were 5 years old, 10 years old, so back in the day.
Well, I listened to so much, you know, so much music when I grew up, because there was always music on at home as well. Mm-hmm. So all this kind of my dad, he's really into like British prog music from late 60s and 70s. So I grew up listening to like a lot of Pink Floyd, Genesis, like Led Zeppelin, stuff like that. So that's really like early influences, and I still, you know, listen to a lot of that music nowadays as well. And here behind me I have
a vinyl
a lot of, and there's lots of these my like childhood albums in there as well.
Even if you have to pick like one of those oldies vinyl behind you, what would you pick?
Sorry?
If you have to pick one of those vinyl, one vinyl record that you have behind you, which one you would pick?
Oh, I don't know. It's these always change. Yeah, they always change, you know, with the years yeah. going by. But yeah, there's some really good ones in there.
I know it's not easy.
But I would probably go with something from the 70s, and probably from England.
Like I said, Genesis is just the most, you know, one of the most famous progressive band. And then just, of course, moving a little bit from today, of course, your career Fintroll is well known, and you played a lot in these days, in these past months. And of course, like, because it's important as well to say that you're going to play in festival summer, because yeah. there are many. So just staying as well, like in the Fintroll side right now. So where we can see you this summer?
Oh yeah, this summer is gonna be kind of fun because we are playing lots of big festivals this summer. So we're starting up in a little bit over 2 weeks. We're starting off with Grass Pop and Hellfest same weekend.
They're really close. So like from another one. Okay.
Yeah. Exactly. It's they're in. In countries close to each other, you know, it's Belgium and France, so it's not far away. And yeah, we're playing Friday, Grass Pop, and Saturday at Hellfest. Yeah, then we have like here in Finland, for example, we play at Tuska, one of the biggest metal festival in Finland. Yeah. Then we have a Wacken opener for the first time in 17 years.
Really? That's huge then.
Yeah, it's been a long time since we played there. I don't remember. What else do we have? We're actually going to Norway as well. Yes.
I know.
Yes, exactly.
I love that.
I'm really looking forward to that one.
That's going to be amazing. Yeah,
I've seen so much pictures from there and it looks so cool. So I'm really looking forward.
Yeah, because I think things were really fit, you know, with the... with Midgardsblot, and since I'm close with some of those people, you know, you see, you know, the fans, the people just talking with each other, and they were like as well when, for example, the organizer, she said, "Well, which band do you expect this year?" There's someone say like Fintroll here, Fintroll there. So I think that I think it's gonna be cool because it's like, you know, something between a spirituality and then you see folk and black metal and then kind of in between. It's weird.
Yeah.
It's
a good mix of everything, yeah.
Yes, exactly. So, and then we can say the festival period is going around to fade in, or it's continuing? Like the live with Fintroll in general?
No, we're going to do the festivals, but we have for the autumn, there's not like any big tours for Fintroll. Coming right now, we are working on something for the end of the year that I cannot really talk about yet, but we're going to take it up a little bit slower and focus on some bigger things for next year, but I will be on a European tour with And Oceans in September,
and then
we're going to do 3 weeks in Europe. This is the first And Oceans tour in Europe in 22 years, I think, or something like that. So.
But that's huge, though. That's huge. Between the after 17 years in Balkan with Fintroll, and so basically you're witnessing a huge moment for the both of the band.
Yeah, exactly.
That's cool. And with Fintroll, you're thinking as well to record, release, working. Let's say working of a new material, kind of working. Let's say I like that.
We have actually not talked really about that yet because, you know, with Fintroll, we need to squeeze everything out of an album, and sort of Corona sort of ruined the plans we had. So so we are actually sort of 2 years late for. So we're gonna tour now, and then maybe we'll think about writing some new material soon. Yeah, let's see what happens. But
I think you need to enjoy a little bit playing live.
Yeah, exactly.
And being on, like, arriving at the point of being like, what the fuck, I'm tired. Now we can, we did too many lives. We can just chill and talk about the new album. Yeah.
Exactly.
Just thinking about it instead of that, because in the first interview, we didn't speak a lot about In the Oceans. So it's a good band. It's a well-known band as well. So I'm going to ask you first how you joined In the Oceans.
Yeah, well, that was sort of one of my, let's say, like, teenage friends' bands. You know, they're from the same small city where I come from, and you know, I was friends with the guitar players of the band and some of the former members as well, and sort of grew up listening to the band because they were, you know, our city's boys. And then at some point I was, not the new album, but the album before, the comeback album, was when we had the recording sessions were coming up. I was actually supposed to produce the album.
Okay.
Because Timo, the guitar player, wanted me to produce the guitar sounds for the album, and also check, you know, with them when they're playing, you know, all the technical stuff in the studio. And so I was like, yeah, it's gonna be cool because, you know, you're good friends of me, and, you know, it's my childhood you know, favorite band and stuff like that, so why not? This is gonna be a cool experience, and I'm really happy that you guys are deciding to make a new album and blah blah blah. And you know, then a couple of months later Timo just calls me and asks me, like, so how do you feel about singing on the album as well? I was like, oh, okay, yeah, maybe I can do that. But yeah, so he just told me that they need a new singer, and you know, him and me, we had some bands back in the day as well. So I was like, yeah, let's do it. We can do it. And then I had to really work hard to get all the lyrics done. There was like 1 month or something until studio sessions would start, so I needed to
work fast.
But yeah, it was kind of kind of a stress, but, you know, got it done and couldn't be happier. And now we already released the second album.
This
comeback era.
Yeah. So and I mean, it's released this year. So I mean, what about this album? Because of course, like you say, you mentioned before, the comeback album.
Yeah.
With the second one. We can say the second comeback album.
Yeah, exactly.
What is, I mean, there's some changes between the first one, like, for example, in the lyrics, in as well, you can say about the technical part as well.
Yeah.
The expert here in this field knows me.
Well, sort of, I would say that we really stepped up the game with the second one. You know, it's, well, the production is way better. We actually, you know, we had a little bit better budget on the second album as well, and we were not that, you know, that stressed out, because when the comeback album came, you know, it was like, let's get it out really fast, let's do it, here we go, yeah, let's get it out now before the fans forget about the band. And but now, you know, when we had the corona period came, we could actually sit back and relax, write music at our own pace, and so we did. We could actually have time to think about it. I wrote the lyrics in maybe a year, maybe, or something.
Yeah, so the time.
And you know, we were not playing with any of the bands really much, any of my bands, like, at all. So maybe like 5 to 10 gigs per year. So
like in 2020, yeah, so really had, for example, 2020 last year.
Yeah, and so we took our time and made it really sound well. So
because it took basically like, I was seeing the Facebook page, like 100,000 stream in a couple of months.
Yeah,
that's good. I mean,
it went sort of viral at some point. So that's really cool.
And about and lyric wise, how is the, I mean, the main topic or the lyrics take, they, you know, their influences from, because like, is in the gardens, so in the tombs, like remind something of, you know, like melancholic, I don't know, you can say.
Well, sort of, but they are they're really connected to my own experience of this this thing called life. You know, it's a I've always been this kind of guy that really puts I have to say, like, I look at the world in a very like mathematical, almost like physical, like physics kind of way. So this 2 albums have been sort of my view of what all the life and, you know, beyond is about, and how
it's a deep
I see it, yeah. Sorry,
it's a deep topic though.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I've always, you know, been sort of fascinated with the mechanics behind life. So this was a really important album to me. So it's more my like philosophies about life, death, afterlife. But on the second album, I took a little bit more, like a different kind of perspective on the whole thing, and watched a lot of documentaries, read a lot about different religions in the world and worldviews and customs around the world, and sort of discovered that, you know, that we all have the same goal, but we are only using different paths to get to the same kind of goal. So that's sort of what the new album is about.
Of seeing life as well. We can take different paths, can be religious, general, methodical, whatever path, but we all do the same things. And to achieve it, which is, I don't know, peace, calmness, whatever we want.
That's exactly.
Yeah. That's fascinating as well, because of course, that fits with Migrant Float. That fits with Migrant Float perfectly. To play that podcast too.
Yeah, we should, yeah. It would be really cool to come to Norway with that band, because, you know, And Oceans was a big part of the, you know, the early black metal scene in Scandinavia, because it was formed in 1994-95. They were
famous true region, like,
yeah, exactly,
period.
Yeah.
So you mentioned that you were going on tour in September. Europe is gonna be the huge European tour or something, gig, and it's basically gigantus, it's enormous tour.
Nice.
Another 180 live.
Yeah, exactly. No, I don't remember how many gigs, but it's like it's like over 3 weekends, and of course gigs in between, so it's almost, yeah, it's like 2.5 weeks in a row with like 1 day off or something. And we're gonna go from, you know, like a lot of west of Europe to a little bit of Eastern Europe as well.
So you're gonna cover basically all the Europe. It's a European tour, that's for a reason.
Yeah, exactly.
But of course, I mean, that's, we're gonna say that's a lot of work to do for you.
Yeah.
But apart from that, you have as well, if I'm not wrong, other projects besides.
Sorry.
Yeah, if I'm not wrong, beside And Oceans and Fintroll, you have other projects.
Yeah, yes, I do.
So,
well, actually, I'm in 2 days. I'm gonna go back to my hometown and practice with this crust punk-ish death metal-ish kind of band over there as well. So that played bass in and sing, and we're gonna play on Friday. We're gonna play here in Finland on a small festival, and
you don't have rest and no dinner one day.
Yeah, exactly. But that's gonna be a cool thing. We haven't done anything with this band now in any gigs since a half year ago.
Okay.
So that's gonna be really cool to do something, and we released this like split 7-inch vinyl this year, but that's the only thing we have released now in a while, and we're gonna actually go through some new songs with that album this week in my hometown, so really looking forward. The band is called Dispute, and it's
So I mean, you basically change genre almost in each project you have. I know that it's not, I mean, but as a singer as well, change your vocal as well, I think.
Definitely. Yeah, I've always wanted to create sort of different folders for my different bands. You know, sometimes when I see other singers or guitar players or something, or drummers, if they do different bands, they always do the same thing. That's that singer because he's doing this thing and this thing, and he does only that thing. But I've always wanted to create something different with my vocals for different bands. So for me, it's been really important to be sort of being able to do everything like punk to brutal death metal.
You could do black an opera. You're missing. It's a epic metal, power metal band.
That I don't have. Yeah, I don't have any power metal bands. It's something that's been really important to me to not repeat myself in the different projects that I have. So
that is good as well, because people don't ask, because usually, when mainly they know you for Fintro. In this, at least for me, since we spoke last 3 years ago, I saw you more, for example, in the Oceans.
Yeah.
So, and of course there is the other band, Dispute. So it's a change, and it's good because you can cover different range vocals, and as well, because I'm Fintro as well, it's like playing a kind of character, like a sort of a theater act, you can say.
Yeah, definitely. I've always thought about it as sort of like theater play. Yeah. A gig is not, it's not a concert in that kind of sense. It's more like, we put on a theater show. And that's something I really like about the band, because, there's this kind of transformation that happens every night when we're on tour.
You just are another person for one night.
Yeah, exactly.
I reach when you like when the actor go to play a character, basically.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, and yeah. But if, for example, in Doshans, I represent myself.
Yeah, exactly.
So then my stage performance also changes.
Yeah.
Because the character I have in Fintroll, he's able to do so much more on the stage. He can do whatever he wants, sort of, but Matthias cannot do the same things. So
that means that you can, that's a good thing if you think about yourself, because I think a lot of people can do that as well, but it's not easy to just one day perform with Fintroll and maybe then other weekend you have to perform with other, change so quickly.
Sometimes it's a little bit weird to do the change. For example, usually if I record an album and the last Fintroll album, we had lots of things. We did a lot of things with the Andoceans before. So I was sort of in Andoceans mode. And then we went into the studio with Fintroll. Yeah, exactly. So we went into the studio to record the new Fintroll album. The first day I recorded I think I did like one or maybe two songs the first day, and then the second day when I came to studio and started listening to what I did, I sort of threw half of it in the trash, because it felt to me too much like something I would do with Andoceans. So I needed to sort of recalibrate my brain into the Fintroll mode. So that sometimes happens when I have those. So, and now it's going to be weird to do the punk thing, for example, on Wednesday.
Okay.
Because I'm so in Fintroll mode right now, so
I don't know, just to listen to some hardcore or just go to some, I don't know, city protest and just get to into the hardcore mode, death metal mode, and just change.
Yeah, probably, yeah. I probably need to do something like that, yeah.
But funny,
and that's a good idea.
I mean, if you want to go into the mood, like, you know, the ambientalist, environmental, city protest, something like that.
Yeah, exactly. I have a lot of punk albums here. So that's good.
Which is one, for example, one, yeah, just hear about punk. If there is some punk band which you enjoy to listen more. Since let's put away the band for a bit.
Let's see if I have some. Nah, I was hoping that I would have something really like in 1 second there, but yeah, I have a couple of Sheet System album that I really like. It's on those albums there's still some people that are now involved in later in At the Gates, and they had this kind of cross punk band back in the days called Sheet System. I really love it. I probably need to listen to that.
Yeah, do it afterwards. Maybe when you're chilling, you just put it yourself in the mood, you know, like the actors do. So basically you're doing sound engineering, singer, your own work, and then you're as well an actor, then we can but as well you collaborated with Elstorm in the album as well.
Yeah.
So another performance changing, okay.
Yeah, I was playing some kind of role of a crocodile, I think, or something like that.
So I mean, it can be hard as well doing all these things, but you did good, because all the time, I mean, you wouldn't be here if you wouldn't do a good job of, you know, you wouldn't have like 1,100 of views. So I think, Fintroll, of course, they have an amazing history, and still today, it's like, you know, like one of the main band in the field. That field, yeah. But I think the Oceans deserve as well a lot to be seen, because it's a good, good music, good project, and in my opinion. And in general, so just to catch a little bit the play. So this summer you're gonna be spread all over the Europe, the festival, let's say it. The first one is gonna be Grass Pop, and then Hellfest. I should be supposed to be at Hellfest too, but I'm not. So then. Back and all around here and there, and always with Fintroll, and because of course a lot of people that go to Midgardsblot will see this interview, so which is going to be a Midgardsblot. You're going to just play one day and just move, or you're going to be like a Midgardsblot moving around?
I think at the Midgardsblot I might be actually working in Norway during that, because I have this rock school here in Seinäjoki, and we have some new partners.
I saw some video on Instagram that's about it's rock camp, rock school, something.
Yeah. It's a small school we have here, and we are working together with some Norwegians right now, and they are also one of the organizers for Midgardsblot. So I might actually stay a couple of days more at Midgardsblot to catch up with them and plan some. We have this like exchange student program going on, so we're going to do some exchange with Norway.
That's cool.
Because they have this kind of rock school-ish over there as well, so we're going to do some student change. Yeah. So I will probably be at Midgardsblot for a little bit longer than just our day.
Yeah, that's a good lineup until now. Enslaved, Maiden Bride, and a lot of folkish band as well. Tudor, I don't know how to pronounce them, sorry if someone is of them.
Good
lineup. And then a huge European tour, and I don't know if you're gonna be in Italy with the Oceans.
Yeah, we're gonna play in Bologna, I think, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm gonna spam it, because I think people should see that one. What can I say? So, Matthias, we're gonna see Midgardsblot for sure, because I'm gonna be there living in between, you know, with the stage, the camera. So.
Oh yeah, that's perfect.
You gonna see that?
But yeah, no, it's gonna be cool.
Yeah, share a beer and have some fun and just enjoy the rest of the day. And thank you as always for the interview. And wish you the best with the Fintroll dispute and then the Oceans. and all the rest. Thank you so much.
Yes. Bye. Thank you.
The rest of the evening.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.